हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम संपदा कुलकर्णी वेलकम्स यू इन माय चैनल टेक टॉक्स। इन दिस वीडियो सीरीज आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू हाउ टू हैंडल फाइल्स इन सी प्लस प्लस। इन दिस करंट वीडियो सेशन आई एम एक्सप्लेनिंग यू देर आर डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ फाइल्स विच वी कैन एक्सेस, फ्रॉम विच आई एम गोइंग टू गिव यू एन इंट्रोडक्शन अबाउट सिक्वेंशियल फाइल्स in C++. In general, what are the sequential files that I am going to explain you in this video. Before moving to the contents, I would like to request you to please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. After subscription, keep the bell ringing, because ringing bell will give you the notification of new videos from my channel. Please do like my video, give the comments, whatever. If you require more things, then you can comment that into the video. So friends, let's start with the content. First of all, I am going to explain you what are different types of files, or in which different ways we can access the content of the files. The first one is the sequential access. In this sequential access, name itself suggests that the data, information or the records are available in the manner in which we are going to access them sequentially, one by one. The another type is indexed sequential access, where sequential is same, only the thing is for every record index is going to maintain. One extra field is we are going to maintain, and with the help of index we can move to the indexed record directly. The third type is direct access or the random access. The names are different, but the thing is same. Like directly we can access any of the record, as well as randomly we can access any of the record which are available in that file. I am going to explain you all these things one by one in the separate videos. So in this current video, I am going to explain you only the sequential access file. Now let's start with the sequential access file. Now, as I explained previously, the information or the records which are present in your file that we are going to process in the sequence. How they are going to process, that I am going to explain you with this figure, where you can consider this as a file. These n number of records are already available in your file, and sequentially one by one means this record, after accessing this record we will move forward for the next record, after accessing the second record we will move forward for the next record, and so on. You will perform the same task to access all the records one by one in the sequence. The next important concept with respect to sequential access file is, whatever the information or the records that we are going to process, that we can process either in forward direction or in the reverse direction, which is also called as rewind, but in the sequence. To explain this concept, again I am having one diagram with which I am going to explain you how this forward and rewind direction is going to maintain. So now let's consider this is your file. Currently my cursor is approximately in the mid of the file, and from this cursor position, if I am performing any of the operation, that is read or write operation, but towards end of the file, this is nothing but the forward direction operation, accessing the records in the forward direction. But oppositely, if from the current position to the beginning of the file or towards the beginning of the file, one by one you are accessing a record, that is nothing but the rewind direction or the reverse direction, or in the opposite direction you are going to access the records. All this process is going to happen by sequence or in the sequence. That's why specifically this type of file is nothing but the sequential access file. Let's move forward. Here I am going to explain you the uses of the sequential file, where different applications where we can implement the sequential file that I am going to explain you. As the sequential file is there, means all the records you are going to access one by one. So whenever we want to access all the records, at that time this sequential file is very useful. So whenever all the records we need to access, we can use the sequential file. So where we can use the sequential file? So let's take one example where you want to update the payroll at the end of the month. Here, where any of the organization, if that organization is going to maintain the payroll, that the organization has to go through each and every employee of that organization. So if I want to access all the records of all the employees, then the sequential file is very useful. The another example is any of the provider, service provider, if they want to send the statement or bills to all the customer, then again here is the thing like all the customers, they want to send the statements or bills to all the customers. So here if all the customers are there, it is benefited to use the sequential file where you can access all the customers one by one. So in this way, these are two examples or the applications where the sequential file can be useful. Let's move forward for the advantages and disadvantages of the sequential file. Let's see the advantages. As I have explained, the basic things with respect to the sequential file, you must come to know that the file is very, the file handling for the sequential file is very simple, and mostly this method is used. As this is very simple, commonly this method can be used by the user. After that, the next advantage is very efficient whenever you want to access all the records or most of the records, we can say. So if I want to access almost all the records, then the sequential file is very efficient or mostly used. Now let's see which are the disadvantages. So disadvantages are, if I want to access few of the records, then also I need to access whole file. So I need to access whole the file, and this is nothing but the disadvantage of the sequential file. And as I want to access all the records, the time complexity required will be very high. That's why the overall processing will also slow. So these are nothing but the disadvantages of the sequential file. So I hope, dear friends, you are able to understand the sequential file, how to access the content or how to access the information from the sequential file. So thank you all friends for listening and watching my video. Please do not forget to give the comment. Here I am providing you the subscription link. Please subscribe my channel Tech Talks. Along with that, I am providing you the link for the next video of this video series. And here I am providing you the playlist for the same video series. Thank you friends. Stay tuned with Tech Talks. Thank you.